Today I'll show you how I built my new bandsaw. This is the first video in a 5 or 6 part series. It's completely made of plywood to make the assembly easier. Once the plywood parts have been cut to size, we'll basically only have to put them together following the plans. I'm going to use birch plywood, although we could also use lighter plywood or MDF. At any rate, it's best to use hard plywood for load-bearing pieces, such as the upper wheel's lifting system. I'll start by machining these two parts. They're the biggest of the bunch and provide the structure for the saw. After cutting them to size, I mark all their rebates according to the plans. I'll remove the riving knife from my table saw for a moment in order to make the inner rebates. Doing so will allow us to cut the pieces evenly. I finished the job with a jigsaw. These are the rebates for the screws that will act as rotation axis in the upper wheel's lifting system. Now I drill these two holes to insert the lower wheel's calibrated rod. I machine these holes with a router, one for the dust collection pipe and one for the motor. This screw will allow us to rotate the table and lock it in place. I'll use this kind of screw so that it won't turn when operating the knob. Here I drill a hole in the plywood for a threaded insert that will allow us to tilt the upper wheel. Now I can glue both pieces and the pieces in between together. I'll sprinkle salt on all the surfaces so that the parts won't move when tightening the clamps. I'll also glue these parts that will act as a buffer and reinforce the structure. While I'm waiting for the glue to dry, I machine this part upon which the saw's guidepost will slide. Then, after cutting it at the desired angle, I can put everything in place. I'll also screw in the buffer for the lower parts of the bandsaw. Now is a good time to make a rebate for the emergency switch. And And now I can finish gluing all the reinforcing buffers together like before. While I'm at it, I can also sand and varnish all the parts, especially the edges. This is the upper wheel's lifting and tilting system. After cutting all the parts, I mark and machine a hole for the wheel's calibrated rod. I'll attach this metal plate to the rear where the screw that regulates the tilt will rotate. I drill holes for the screws that will act as rotation axis and screw them together. I attach this other part that will allow us to separate the upper bearings a little bit more. Now I machine the other part of the lifting system. Here I drill a hole for the screw that will lift the whole set. I've made some rebates on the heads of these screws, allowing easier removal after they've been put in place. Mounting the lifting system on the bandsaw is quite easy. First, I put in this part from the front and the other part from the top, having put in the screws or axis. We line up the holes and insert the screws. I'm going to build the cover for the bandsaw by gluing these two parts together. I drill a hole here so that I can lift the upper wheel. By tensing the blade, this part will bend and will act as a spring, preventing the saw from vibrating. I mark the position of the upper frontal bearing. I'll use this adjustable bit for this task. First, I tried it on another piece of plywood. The hole has to be tight so that the bearing is firmly attached to the board. As you can see, using a cheap bit and this drill makes this difficult, but little by little I managed to drill the hole. Now I insert the bearing using this metal plate. Since the central axis of the bearing is a few tenths of a millimeter smaller than the outer ring, I won't damage it. I do this carefully, little by little, trying to make it level with the plywood. Finally, I make sure the bearing has been inserted evenly, which is a must if we want to prevent vibrations and ensure the saw works properly. I screw the part in place. I'll use a couple of dowels for a stronger bond. Now I'll attach the lower frontal bearing. First of all, I have to trim the plywood part a few millimeters so that it doesn't stick out further than the upper part. I repeat the same steps as before, and after putting it in its exact position, I can screw the part in place. For now, I'll only use a couple of screws. Later on, I'll finish screwing it in. To finish this video, I'll screw the bandsaw onto the stand. First, I drill and countersink the position of the screws in this part. The part itself can be used as a reference to mark the position of the threaded inserts on the stand I built a few days earlier, which you can see in the previous video on my channel. Now I screw the plywood part onto the saw according to the plans. I also screw this other part in for a stronger bond, and now I can place the bend saw on its stand. In a few days, I'll upload the next video detailing how I built the saw's wheels. See you soon!